إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله, الله سبحانه وتعالى has allowed us to witness another Jumu'ah, and as we know, the countdown has begun for the month of Ramadan in just a few days. Just a few days, the blessed month of Ramadan will begin. And inshallah ta'ala, we'll open up the khutbah by mentioning some lines of poetry in the welcoming of Ramadan, as written by one of the scholars. He says, مرحباً مرحباً بشهر الصيام مرحباً مرحباً بشهر القيام مرحباً مرحباً بشهر كريم خصنا الله فيه بالإكرام يا لذا الشهر من خصائص تجلى وله في النفوس أعلى المقام وبه ليلة تزيد بفضل وبفيض عن ألف شهر تسامي فهنيئاً لمن يفوز بحظ في ليالي الصيام والأيام فاستعدوا له ببشر وقولوا مرحباً مرحباً بشهر الصيام. Rough translation, welcome, welcome to the month of fasting. Welcome, welcome to the month of standing. Welcome, welcome to the noble month in which Allah has exalted us with honor. Oh, what a month of manifest values, virtues, which occupies in the souls the highest distinction. It is a night, in it is a night which exceeds 1,000 nights in favor and abundance. So congratulations to the one who wins a share in the nights and days of fasting. So prepare for it with joy and say welcome, welcome to the month of fasting. So the month of Ramadan is coming up, and there is no other month comparable to the month of Ramadan out of all the 12 months of the year. Possibly the month of Dhul Hijjah comes slightly close in terms of virtues and blessings, but no other month comes even close to the exclusive virtues and benefits and blessings of the month of Ramadan. And what we'll mention inshallah here today in the khutbah are 15 special virtues of the month of Ramadan that cannot be found in any other month. Or they can be found in other months, but not the same level as we find it in Ramadan. So we begin. The very first exclusive virtue of the month of Ramadan, it is the month of fasting. It is the month of fasting. There's no other month in the entire year where fasting is obligatory. You can fast any other time. Throughout the year you can fast, as long as you're not fasting on the day of Eid, the two Eids, and as long as you're not singling out the day of Friday or the day of Saturday, according to some of the scholars, then you can fast any other time of the year. But all that is voluntary fasting. As for the mandatory fasting, no other month do you have to fast mandatory fasting except in the month of Ramadan. And the virtues of fasting and the rewards of fasting, the blessings of fasting, are too much to mention in this short time. But we'll mention just a few things for the purpose of reminder and benefit. So what is the purpose of fasting? Allah Azza wa Jal has clearly outlined what is the purpose of fasting. In Surah Al-Baqarah, the very famous verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed for you as it has been prescribed for those before you, so that you may attain taqwa, you may attain the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And fasting is a unique act of worship. No other act of worship is like fasting, because it is a ibadah tarkiyah. It is an ibadah where it's not about what you're doing, it is about what you're not doing. Fasting is all about what you are avoiding. It doesn't require you to actually do anything. It's what you are not doing. You're not eating, you're not drinking, you're not fulfilling your desires, and this is what fasting is about. And because of this, Allah Azza wa Jal has given the reward of fasting, or He has specified, or He has not specified the reward of fasting. As it comes in the hadith Qudsi, As-sawmu li wa ana ajzibi. Allah Azza wa Jal says that fasting is for me, and I will reward it however I please. There's no specified reward Fasting, the reward is unlimited. There is no, we can't put a number on it, as we do for the other deeds. As it comes in other hadiths and ayat, that any reward you do, any good deed, will either be from 10 all the way up to 700 rewards. That's the general range of good deed rewards. But for fasting, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bihi," that it is for me, and I will reward. I will choose a reward. It's not limited by any certain number. Fasting is an opportunity for us to train our souls. And as our imams have mentioned, Imam Al-Ghazali mentions about fasting, it is an opportunity for us to resemble the angels. Resemble the angels. Because what do we do when we're fasting? We are giving up food, we're giving up drink, and we're giving up our desires. And these are qualities of the malaika. These are qualities of the angels. The angels, they don't eat, they don't drink, and they don't have any desires. They don't have any desires. As we know, it comes in the Quran, when Allah sent angels to Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, to give him the glad tidings of a son, and to warn him about the punishment that would come to the people of Lut, Allah sent angels in the form of men. And they came to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam as guests. But they're in the form of human beings. But he came to them as guests. Or they came to him as guests. And so Ibrahim alayhi salam, he went to his family and he brought ijlin sameen. He brought a nice big fat lamb. And he brought it near to them. فَقَرَّبُوا إِلَيْهِمْ. But they were not eating. وَقَالَ أَلَا تَأْكُلُونَ. Why are you not eating? These are guests, they're not eating. And Ibrahim alayhi salam started to feel a bit of fear. And he felt a bit scared. فَلَمَّا رَأَى أَيْدِيهُمْ لَا تَصِلُ إِلَيْهِ نَكِرَهُمْ وَأَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفَةً. When he saw that their hands are not extending to the plate, they're not eating, he started to feel a bit scared. And he wanted to know, who are these people? What kind of guests are going to refuse food? And then they said, قَالُوا لَا تَخَفْ إِنَّا أُرْسِلْنَا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِ لُوتٍ. They said, don't be scared, we are messengers who have been sent to the people of Lut. And the reason why they're not eating, because they are angels. They don't eat and they don't drink. And the angels don't have desires like human beings have. And this is the distinguishing quality between the human beings, and then we have the animals, and then we have the angels. As comes in some of the Salaf, they have made a statement. They said, رَكَبَ اللَّهُ فِي الْمَلَائِكَةِ الْعَقْلَ بِلَا شَهْوَةٍ وَفِي الْبَهَائِمِ الشَّهْوَةِ بِلَا عَقْلٍ وَفِي ابْنِ آدَمَ كِلَيْهِمَا فَمَنْ غَلَبَ عَقْلُهُ شَهْوَتَهُ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَمَنْ غَلَبَ شَهْوَتَهُ وَعَقْلَهُ فَهُوَ شَرٌ مِنَ الْبَهَائِمِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed the malaika, he gave them intellect, but he did not give them desires. And he has put the animals with desires, but no intellect. And he has placed in the son of Adam both desire and intellect. So whoever his intellect overcomes his desire, then he is better than the angels. He's better than the angels. And whosoever desires overcome his intellect, then he is worse than the animals. He's worse than the animals. And this is mentioned in the Quran where Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنْهُمْ إِلَّا كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. That they are like the animals, the wild animals, actually they are even more misguided. So if we don't use our intellect and use it to overcome our desires, then we are worse than the animals. So fasting is an opportunity for us to resemble the angels in leaving off our food, leaving off our drink, leaving off our desires. As it comes in the hadith, يَدَعُ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ وَشَهْوَتَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي. He leaves off his food and his drink and his desires for my sake. The second special virtue of Ramadan is that it is the month of the Qur'an. It is the month of the Qur'an. Allah Azza wa Jal has informed us that the month of Ramadan is the month in which the Qur'an was revealed. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. That the month of Ramadan is the month in which the Qur'an was revealed. Specifically, it was revealed on the night of Al-Qadr. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Allah, as Allah Azza wa Jalla says, that we have revealed it on the night of Al-Qadr. And it's no secret that the Prophet ﷺ has linked these two acts. So what we mentioned in the first, that Ramadan is the month of fasting. And Ramadan is the month of the Qur'an. The Prophet ﷺ has linked these two together. And he said in the hadith, الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. That the siyam, fasting, and the Quran will make intercession for the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment. So these two things are the keys for Ramadan. Everything else we'll mention afterwards is extra. But these two things, if you want to have a successful Ramadan, then of course after the Salah is the most important, but this is outside and inside of Ramadan. But for Ramadan, if you want to have a successful Ramadan, the key is these two things that we've just mentioned. The fasting and the Quran. The fasting is an obligatory deed. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Hadith Qudsi, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا افْتَرَدْتُ عَلَيْهِ, that my slave does not draw near to me with anything more beloved to me than the obligatory deeds. You need to focus on the obligatory. Sometimes we tend to look towards all the other nawafil, the taraweeh, and the voluntary charity, and all these other things, and we neglect the most important things, which are the fard, the wajib, the salah, first and foremost, and then the siyam, which is what is main highlight of the month of Ramadan. So we need to focus on the siyam, make sure that we know what fasting, what breaks the fast, what nullifies the fast, what are the things that enhance the fast, the sunnah of the fasting, the things that are disliked, and all other rulings related to fasting is important, because this is the crux of the month of Ramadan. The third exclusive virtue of the month of Ramadan is that Ramadan is the month of Qiyam, the month of standing, praying at night. We can stand in any other month and pray. The Salat al-Tahajjud, Salat al-Qiyam is available any other night, but not in the format that we have in the month of Ramadan, where every single night we all gather together and we pray in jama'ah, congregation, a certain amount of raka'at behind one imam. This is exclusive to the month of Ramadan, and there are many blessings and virtues of this, amongst which the Prophet ﷺ said, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." That whoever stands in Ramadan and expecting the reward, then Allah will forgive all his previous sins. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ says, "Man qama ma'al imam hatta yansarifa kutiba lahu qiyamu layla." If you stand, now any other time of the year, if you want to attain the benefit of, or the reward of standing the entire night, you actually have to stand the entire night from hours and hours until end, until the break of dawn, if you want to attain the full reward of Qiyam. In the month of Ramadan, Allah has made things easy. As the Prophet ﷺ says, if you stay with the Imam until he leaves, كُتِبَ لَهُ قِيَامُ لَيْلَى, that this person may be written for him as if he stood the entire night. So you stand, Taraweeh is maybe what, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, even less these days because of the restrictions. You stand this short amount of time, and you can get the reward of praying the entire night. We're praying the entire night. So Ramadan is the month of Qiyam. Ramadan is the month of Laylatul Qadr. The fourth exclusive virtue of Ramadan is the month of Laylatul Qadr. No other month has Laylatul Qadr because it's only one night in the entire year. And it is befitting that Allah Azza wa Jalla chose the month of Ramadan to make the night of Laylatul Qadr, which is better than 1,000 months. 1,000 months. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. That the night of Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. When is it in Laylatul Qadr? When is the month of Laylatul Qadr exactly? We don't know. The Prophet ﷺ has told us, look for it in the last 10 days of Ramadan. But we don't know the exact night. It has not been revealed to us for wisdoms that Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best. However, it is definitely in the month of Ramadan. Exclusive virtue number 5 of the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of forgiveness. And this ties into what we just mentioned of the two previous things. As the Prophet ﷺ says, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever stands in the night in the nights of Ramadan, in Ramadan, Allah will forgive him of all his previous sins. And then the Prophet ﷺ says in another hadith, "Man qama laylatul qadr imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Same thing, if you stand on Laylatul Qadr with iman and expectation of the reward, Allah will forgive you of all your sins before. And then we have the general forgiveness of the month of Ramadan, in which the Prophet ﷺ said, "As-salawatu al-khams wal-jum'ah ila al-jum'ah wa Ramadan ila Ramadan mukaffiratun ma baynahun idha ijtanaba al-kaba'ir." That between each of the 5 salawat, the five daily salawat, and between each Jumu'ah, from one Jumu'ah to the next, and from one Ramadan to the next, is a expiation of sins, as long as you avoid the major sins. So Ramadan is the month of forgiveness. Exclusive virtue number 6 of the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of dua, accepted dua. Dua is open to everyone throughout the year at any time. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ وَدُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, call on me, I will answer you whenever. The door of dua is open anytime. But not all dua is the same. Some duas are more worthy of being accepted than others. Sometimes in places, your dua is more likely to be accepted than others. And in Ramadan is an opportunity for dua that will not be rejected. And that is the dua of the fasting for a person. As the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, ثَلَاثٌ لَا تُرَدُّ دَعْوَتُهُمْ الْإِمَامُ الْعَادِلُ وَالصَّائِمُ حِينَ يُفْتِرُ وَدَعْوَةُ الْمَذْلُومِ. That three people, their du'as are not rejected, are not turned away. The first is the righteous imam. The second is the sa'im, the fasting person until he breaks his fast. And the third is the mazlum, the person who's been oppressed. So Ramadan is the month of accepted du'a. This is the prime time, prime opportunity for 30 days or 29 days where you have majority of the day your du'a is accepted. Majority of the day your du'a is accepted. Exclusive virtue number 7 of the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of sabr, the month of patience. Our scholars have mentioned, Ibn Qayyim mentions that there are three types of patience. Patience is of three types. وَهُوَ ثَلَاثَةُ أَنْوَاعُ صَبْرٌ عَلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى امْتِحَانِ اللَّهِ. The patience is three types. The first is patience on the obedience of Allah. The second is patience on avoiding the prohibitions of Allah, the ma'asiyatillah, the things that Allah has prohibited. And the third is patience on tests, tribulations, trials and tribulations. Ramadan encompasses all three types of patience. All three types of patience are, the opportunity is there in the month of Ramadan for all three types. Because when we're fasting, this is ta'a, this is obedience. And so this is the first type. Because when we're fasting, this is an act of ibadah. We are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, getting up every single day and eating the suhoor and then fasting throughout the day. This is ta'at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is a type of patience. The second type of patience is sabrun ala ma'asiyatillah. Patience in avoiding the things that Allah has prohibited. And this is also an opportunity for us in the month of Ramadan. Because even things outside of Ramadan, we have to avoid the things that have been prohibited. But even in Ramadan, we have things that are normally not prohibited, such as eating and drinking and fulfilling desires with a person's wife. But now in the month of Ramadan, they become haram. They become ma'asi. They become things that are not allowed. And so this requires patience. And so the second type of patience is also present when we are fasting in the month of Ramadan. And the third type of patience is patience on masa'ib, tribulations, trials, tribulations, calamities. And when we're fasting, what are we doing? We are avoiding food and drink. We are experiencing hunger. And hunger is a type of musibah. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. That we will surely try you with things from fear and hunger. So Allah has mentioned hunger as a type of calamity. And those who, then at the end of the verse, he says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. And give glad tidings to those who are patient in the face of all of these calamities. So Ramadan is the month of patience. And patience, what is the reward of patience? Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. That we, verily, we will reward those who are patient without any limits. بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, without any limits. And remember what we said about fasting right at the beginning, where Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bi, wa ana ajzi bi." That fasting is for me, and I reward it as I will. Right? We see the connection here between Allah saying that fasting is for Him; He will reward without any limits. And then, what is the reward of the patient person? Bi ghayri hisab, without any limits. Fasting is all about patience. Ramadan is the month, exclusive virtue number 8 of the month of Ramadan. It is the month of generosity. Month of generosity. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous of people, and he was most generous in the month of Ramadan when he would meet with Jibril. And wa kana Jibrilu yalqahu fi kulli layla min Ramadan. Jibril would meet him every single night in the month of Ramadan. Fa yudarisuhu al-Quran, and Jibril would review the Quran with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Fa Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam hina yalqahu Jibril ajwadu bil khayr min ar-rih al-mursala. That the Prophet ﷺ was more generous when he met Jibril than a very strong and fast wind. So Ramadan is the month of generosity, many opportunities for generosity in the month of Ramadan, because everyone is fasting, so everyone needs food, and everyone needs drink. So everyone is in need of generosity. If you feed the fasting person, مَنْ فَطَّرَ صَائِمًا كَانَ لَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِهِ غَيْرَ أَنَّهُ لَا يَنْقُسُ مِنْ أَجْرِ الصَّائِمِ شَيْئًا. Whoever feeds a fasting person will have the reward of that fasting person. You have the same exact reward of that fasting person, and nothing decreases from your reward, and nothing decreases from their reward. So Ramadan is the month of generosity, and this is the eighth point. Inshallah, we'll mention the rest in the second khutbah. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Exclusive virtue number 9 of the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of i'tikaf. I'tikaf is a act of worship in which we enter the masjid and we make our niyyah that we are staying in the masjid for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would make i'tikaf during the last 10 nights of Ramadan. It's not limited to that. You can make i'tikaf anytime inside of Ramadan or even outside of Ramadan. And according to some of the scholars, it could even be as short as a moment. There's no limit on the length of time. You can make i'tikaf anytime for any amount of time, and it is not limited by a certain time limit. But in the month of Ramadan, the Prophet ﷺ would single out this month, specifically the last 10 days, for i'tikaf, and not only him but also his wives. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر شد مئزره وأحيا ليله وأيقظ أهله. When the last 10 nights of Ramadan would enter, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would he would fasten his izar, his clothing, and he would stay up the night, and he would awake his family. He would wake up his family for salah and ibadah. So Ramadan is the month of i'tikaf. It is the only month in which we have example of the Prophet ﷺ spending 10 nights, during the last 10 nights, and staying in the masjid and not leaving the masjid. But as we said, i'tikaf is not limited to that. If you cannot stay the 10 nights, you can stay 5 nights, you can stay 1 night, you could even come to the masjid and intend i'tikaf for 5 minutes. And this will be valid inshallah. So let's not lose out on the blessings of i'tikaf in the month of Ramadan, especially during the last 10 nights. Exclusive virtue number 10 of the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is the month of unity and gathering. No other month do the Muslims gather like they gather in the month of Ramadan. Maybe during Hajj we have a big gathering, but that's only for the Hujjaj who go and have the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be there for Hajj. But in the month of Ramadan, we see many faces that we have not seen throughout the years. Maybe because of whatever the circumstances are, we reconnect with many of our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters. And Ramadan is the month of unity and gathering. We're all gathering in the masajid, starting fasting at one time, ending fasting at the same time, praying together. It's the month of unity. Exclusive virtue number 11 of the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month in which the doors of paradise are opened. No other month in the year do the gates of paradise open, and do the gates of paradise or the gates of hellfire close. This is 11 and 12. And 13, the shayateen are chained up. And this all comes in one hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ said that إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانَ فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ جَهَنَّمِ وَصُفِدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. that when the month of Ramadan comes, the gates of paradise are opened, and the gates of hellfire are shut, and that shayateen, the devils, are chained up. This is 11, 12, and 13. No other month are the gates of paradise open, and no other month are the gates of hellfire shut, and no other month are the shayateen chained up. How are they chained up? Allahu a'lam. We don't know the reality of it, but the first thing we are required of as believers is to have iman in al-ghayb. This is the very first thing where Allah praises the believers. In Surah Al-Baqarah, when He describes the qualities of the believers, He says, "Alladhina yu'minuna bil-ghayb," that they are those who believe in the unseen. And this is very important, because sometimes when we come to a hadith like this, the first thing people want to do is ask, how are they chained up? Is it real chains, or is it literal, or is it metaphoric? Are the big shayateen chained up, or is it only the small ones? And all these questions, why is there evil still in Ramadan? What we have to do when we hear a hadith like this is we believe in the ghaib. The Prophet ﷺ said that the shayateen are chained up. Allahu a'lam how this will be done, but this is a fact and reality. Exclusive virtue number 14 for the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of Zakatul Fitr. There are only two types of charity that are mandatory on us as Muslims. Only two times where Allah demands us to give our wealth for His sake. That is Zakatul Mal, the yearly charity that's due yearly, on a yearly basis, inside of Ramadan, outside of Ramadan, depending on a person's specific circumstances, and Zakatul Fitr, which is due at the end of Ramadan. Now, Zakatul Fitr is actually not paid in Ramadan. Its time enters after Ramadan. So it's actually paid in the month of Shawwal. So why do we place it as a virtue of Ramadan when it's actually paid in Shawwal? Because the reason for it is Ramadan. The reason why Zakatul Fitr has been legislated is for Ramadan. As the Prophet ﷺ says in a hadith, فَرَضَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ زَكَاتِ الْفِطْرُ تُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ, that Allah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, He mandated, obligated Zakatul Fitr as a purification for the fasting person. تُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ مِنَ اللَّغْوِ وَالرَّفَثِ وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ, as a way of purifying the fasting person from any type of false speech and any other things that spoil the fast, and as a way of feeding the masakeen, the poor people. And من أداها قبل الصلاة فهي زكاة مقبولة, whoever pays the zakat al-fitr before the salah, before salat al-eid, then this will be the zakat that is accepted and fulfills the obligation of that person. So Zakat al-Fitr is exclusively legislated because of the month of Ramadan to purify our fasting from any mistakes or any shortcomings that we may have had in it. And so it is exclusively tied to the month of Ramadan. Exclusive virtue number 15, and the final exclusive virtue that we mentioned today, inshallah, Ramadan is the month of victory. Ramadan is the month of victory. We look throughout the history of Islam and the Muslims, we will find that many of the major battles, many of the conquests were completed in the month of Ramadan. Starting first and foremost with the Battle of Badr. The Battle of Badr was in Ramadan, the 17th of Ramadan. As Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in the Quran, He calls it Yawm al-Furqan, Yawm al-Taqal Jama'an. This is the day of decisiveness when Allah Azza wa Jalla allowed the Muslims to gain victory. And this was the very first victory over the Mushrikeen, the polytheists of Mecca. The Battle of Badr occurred during the month of Ramadan. Fathu Mecca, when the Prophet ﷺ conquered Mecca, this also occurred in the month of Ramadan. There's a battle called Buwayb, which was a battle that was fought between the Muslims during the time of Umar radiallahu anh and the Sassanid Persian Empire, which was a major decisive battle that brought the Persian Empire closer to its fall. And the Muslims, they were able to accomplish in a few years what the Roman Byzantine Empire were not able to accomplish in hundreds of years. They had a rival between the Byzantines, the Romans, and the Persians, and they were at each other's throats for hundreds of years, or maybe less than that. But they were not able to bring the downfall of the Persian Empire. They were the two superpowers at that time. And within a few years, the Muslims were able to accomplish what the Romans were not able to accomplish in all that time. And in such a short amount of time, to the point where the historians, they're still not able to understand how the Persian Sassanid Empire fell so quickly, dissolved quickly, completely wiped out from the face of the earth in just a few years, during the time of Umar radiallahu anhu. So one of the major battles that occurred was the Battle of Buwayb, and this was a precursor to the fall of the Sassanid Persian Empire. Also during this time, in the month of Ramadan, the liberation of Al-Quds, Salah ad-Din al-Ayyubi, he conquered Jerusalem in the month of Ramadan. And also during the month of Ramadan, they had a very famous battle called the Battle of Ain Jalut, which was fought against the Mongols. The Mongols ransacked the entire Muslim world, and they sacked Baghdad, which was the capital of the Islamic Empire, and they killed thousands and thousands and thousands of people, and they threw all the books into the river, and they were going nonstop throughout the Muslim world, like an avalanche coming downhill, no one stopping them, until the Muslims met at the Battle of Ain Jalut, and it was a decisive victory for the Muslims, and this halted the advance of the Mongols from that time, and they were never able to advance any further into the Islamic territory. So the Ramadan is the month of victory, and it's not only victory in the battlefield, it's victory in anything that we're dealing with, any problem that we're looking to victory for victory in, any type of issues or problems or anything we're trying to overcome, we use the month of Ramadan as a time that we can, inshallah, overcome whatever we're trying to overcome. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wa'fu anna. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat. Allahumma arham mawtana wa mawt al muslimin. Allahumma ashfi mardana wa mardal muslimin. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. اذكروا الله يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيم الصلاة